What if your notes could talk? Even better, what if you could have a two-way conversation with your written notes? You'd ask them a question and they would answer back. Okay, here's a scoop. So a lot of you might already know that originally with NotebookLM, you could use your notes to create an engaging podcast where two AI hosts would learn from your notes and then have an interactive, lively discussion about them. It was a passive interaction. They would talk, you would listen. But now you can jump in and join the conversation. You can actually engage with the AI host. You can ask the podcasters questions, you can ask them to dive deeper, and you'll get a personalized response in real time. They will listen to you and then they will answer back. Let me show you how you can do this. Let's roll. Using the call-in feature is super simple. All you have to do is upload your sources. Now, these can be anything from PDFs to Google Docs, Google Slides, YouTube videos, websites. You can even go ahead and paste your text within the notebook. Then you're going to go ahead and click the interactive mode button. When you click play, AI hosts are going to begin the discussion on your notes. You know what? You can jump in and join the conversation. Click that blue button to join. And guess what? It's gonna feel like a real conversation. You can interrupt them, then ask questions, and ask for clarification, and ask them to dive deeper on a certain topic.
It's pretty wild when you think about it, how much AI is just seamlessly integrated into our lives. We're interacting with it constantly without even realizing it.
Oh, hey there, what's up?
Hey, I was just curious, how are people using GenAI?
That's a great question.
It actually ties in really well with what we were just discussing about AI being everywhere.
Yeah, like we were just about to get into some of the specific ways that people are using AI in their daily lives. So that's really great timing.
Exactly. And it goes beyond just those background processes. You might be surprised by the huge variety of ways people are using it.
So according to the research we got, a lot of people use AI to answer tests or emails. About 45% of folks are using it for that.
And that makes sense. A lot of AI is built into our phones and computers, so you're likely using it even if you don't know it.
Exactly. So,
go for it.
Do people have any criticisms around AI?
Sounds like you're worried about the downsides of AI.
It's a valid concern, and something we've been planning to discuss. It's important to acknowledge the risks.
Yeah, we can't just focus on the cool and helpful things that AI does. We gotta talk about the potential for trouble, too.
Exactly, and our sources do highlight some of these concerns, like the potential for bias and misuse.
Right, I mean, we've already seen how AI could be used to create fake information or spread propaganda. That's pretty trivial.
And even when AI is used maliciously, there's the issue of unintended consequences, like job displacement or over-reliance on technology.
So yeah, there are definitely some potential pitfalls. It's not all sunshine and rainbows with AI, that's for sure.
Precisely. And I think it's good that you're thinking critically about these things. It's important for all of us to be aware.
If you have not tried this yet, you have to try this because this completely blew my mind. The AI podcasters listened to my question and then answered it in real time. Delay was absolutely minimal. It was just like talking to real live people. If you try this, you have got to let me know how it goes. Leave me a comment below and let me know. I want to know if you found this as fascinating as I do. So when I first opened this new account, I didn't see that interactive mode feature available. But after about 20 minutes or so, it magically appeared. So if you end up in the same situation, just try giving it a little bit of time and see if it comes up. Interactive mode is still in beta and it is being released to users slowly. So you might just have to wait to get access. It is free and it is available on the free plan. Okay, here's a super cool thing about NotebookLM. It never hallucinates. Yep, it never hallucinates. And that's because it's only using the sources that you've put into the notebook as reference material. If it doesn't know the answer, it's not gonna make it up. It'll just tell you. If you've got some notes and you've got some data and you want to just have a sounding board to discuss your ideas, well, NotebookLM is a pretty great way to do so. Is this the first step in making AI feel more like a collaborator than just a tool? What do you think? How would you use NotebookLM? Let me know in the comments below. If you're curious about AI tools and how to use them, well, give us a subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.